Hello students, I welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. I hope you all are doing well at home and at the same time you are studying for your 9th standard, because next year you are going to go in 10th standard, so you have to study. We are doing revision of chapter number 5, linear equations in two variables. Chapter number 6 and 7 are omitted under the 25% deducted syllabus because of this COVID-19 pandemic. So I am not going to discuss those chapters. Previously I told that I will discuss, but since they are not going to come in examination, no questions will be asked, I will not discuss them. But I will advise you that all of you please go through all the important concepts. That means you self-study those two chapters, chapter number 6 and chapter number 7. The reason I have told that these two chapters are there in 10th standard again with the same name, financial planning and statistics. Okay, so to understand them, you have to self-study them. So read all the concepts from the textbook. In textbook, everything is given in very nice manner. Okay, so read the textbook and try to understand the concept so that at least some concepts or some terms you will find them familiar next year. Okay, so I hope you will follow the instructions. Now let us go further in this revision lecture. In the previous lectures we have revised all the topics. Okay, and here we are solving now word problems based on simultaneous equations. This chapter is very small, only two practice sets are present in that. So practice set 5.1 is revised. At the same time, we have done the revision of the solved examples from the textbook. All of you please go through solved examples because they are equally important and they can be asked in examination. Okay, so please go through them. Now we have started with practice set 5.2 and in that we have completed two sums. So let us go further in practice set 5.2. We have completed two questions. Now we are moving towards third question. Okay. So the third question is, the sum of ages of Priyanka and Deepika is 34 years. Priyanka is older to Deepika by 6 years. Then find their today's ages. Okay. So here also, after reading the question, you have to understand the question. Okay. So what we can understand here is, this is first condition given, the sum of ages of Priyanka and Deepika is 34 years, and this is second condition given, Priyanka is elder to Deepika by 6 years. Then find their today's ages. So here we have to assign variables to the quantities. The two quantities are what? Priyanka's age and Deepika's age. So we are going to take their ages as X and Y. Okay, today's ages or present ages. So we have to start with this, that let the ages of Priyanka and Deepika be X years and Y years respectively. Okay, or you can write down, let the present age of Priyanka be X years and that of Deepika be Y years. This way also you can write. Now we have to make use of the conditions. The first condition, the sum of the ages of Priyanka and Deepika is 34 years. Okay, so sum means what? Addition. And their ages are what? X and Y. So here we are going to get the first equation very easily according to the first condition, or from the first condition what we can write is X plus Y is equal to 34. Okay, this was very easy condition, so we can easily write down the equation. And the equation is in standard form also, so number it as 1. Now let us read the second condition. Priyanka is elder to Deepika by 6 years. Priyanka's age we have taken as X and Deepika's age we have taken as Y. Priyanka is elder, that means value of X is bigger. Difference between them is what? 6. So what we can write down from the second condition is, see, Priyanka is elder. So Priyanka's age is written X here first. E stands for equal to. And Deepika by 6 years. So Y plus 6 is written. For those who can understand here that Priyanka is elder and Deepika is younger, that means difference between their ages is 6. So simply you can write down x minus y is equal to 6. There is no need to write this. If you can understand, if you can make it out that the difference between them is 6 years, you can write down x minus y is equal to 6. This is your equation 2. Okay. So the important work of framing the equations is done. Now next thing is to solve these two equations. So I told you that you have to observe their coefficients. Observe the coefficient of variable x. The coefficients are equal. Here also the coefficients are equal, 1 and 1. So either we can add or we can subtract. If we want to eliminate x, we can subtract. If we want to eliminate y, we can add. But always you know that addition is better option. So go for addition. Because when you go for subtraction, you need to change the signs and all. So better go for the easy method. So what we are doing, we are adding equations 1 and 2. So write down equation 1 up, then the sign of plus, that is addition. Just below that write down equation number 2. Okay. So this way we have arranged the equations. Vertical method we are using to add the equations. Now this plus y and minus y, that will give us 0. And in this way y is eliminated. And here x plus x is 2x. And here 34 plus 6, that is 40. So what we are going to get? 2x is equal to 40. And therefore x is equal to 40 divided by 2. That is x is equal to 20. Okay, so we got value of x. Now the next step is to get the value of second variable, that is x. So you have to make use of any one equation here. So you can make use of equation 1. What you are going to write? Substituting x is equal to 20 in equation 1. And then we can get value of y. Okay. So we will solve it afterwards. First of all, you copy down this much part. Okay. And those who will complete it early, they can go ahead. They can solve by themselves the next part. Otherwise, I am going to do only. But before going to the next slide, you please copy down this. Okay, so if you follow the method properly, if you go on solving properly after reading the question, you are going to get the correct answer here. Okay. Write down each and every step. Be careful about sign. As I have said here, if you don't write this directly also, you can write down the equation if you can understand the statement here. Okay. So let us go further now. This value of x, that is x is equal to 20, we are going to substitute in equation 1. So write down, substituting x is equal to 20 in equation 1. What is our equation 1? X plus y is equal to 34. Okay, this is our equation 1. Now in place of x, we are going to write 20. So our next step what? Therefore, 20 plus y is equal to 34. We are replacing x by 20. Now this 20 we will shift to right hand side. So we will get value of y. So what we can write down the next step as? Therefore y is equal to 34 minus 20. That is y is equal to 14. So we got both the values. X is equal to 20 and y is equal to 14. But since it's a word problem, our final answer should be as a statement. Okay, so take help of the first statement to write down the final answer. Okay, what is x? X is the age of Priyanka and y is the age of Deepika. So to write down, therefore Priyanka's age is 20 years and Deepika's age is 14 years. Or you can write down, the age of Priyanka is 20 years and age of Deepika is 14 years. Okay, but writing this final answer is very, very important. This carries half mark. Don't forget to write it. Please copy it down. Okay, I hope you must have completed it. Let us go towards the next question. Question number 4. The total number of lions and peacocks in a certain zoo is 50. The total number of their legs is 140. Then find the number of lions and peacocks in the zoo. Okay, so the question we have read. Now, you will find that the first statement is the first condition. The total number of lions and peacocks in a zoo is 50. This is first condition. And second condition is what? The total number of their legs is 140. Then find the number of lions and peacocks in the zoo. So here, whatever unknowns are there, those we are going to take as what? X and Y. We will assign variable X to the number of lions and variable Y to the number of peacocks. So we will start from that. Let the number of lions be X and the number of peacocks be Y. Or let there are X lions and Y peacocks in the zoo. You can write down the statement as you want. Okay. Either you can write down let the number of lions be X and let the number of peacocks be Y. Or you can write down let there be X lions and Y peacocks in the zoo. Now let's make use of the first condition. From the first condition, see. The total number of lions and peacocks is 50. So first equation, very easily you can write down. See, these are number of lions and these are number of peacocks. And total means what? Their sum is 50. So what we can write down? X plus Y is equal to 50. This is our equation number 1. Okay. Now here, in second condition, the total number of their legs. Now see, lions are having what? 4 legs. One lion is having 4 legs. So we have to write down that. And therefore, total number of legs of lions are how many? 4x. And peacock, they have 2 legs. Okay, so peacock has 2 legs. And therefore, total number of legs of peacocks are how many? 2y. And their total means again their addition we have to do. So that is how much? 140. Okay. So what we can write down by the second condition, that 4x plus 2y is equal to 140. Don't number it as 1 in hurry. Because what we can observe here is we can simplify it further. If we divide the equation by 2, if we divide both the sides by 2, then we will get the simpler equation as 2x plus y is equal to 70. Okay, so don't give number here. You give number to here. Okay, always try to reduce it if possible. So, both the equations we got. Okay, now the next thing is to solve them. So, we are going to solve them by observing the coefficients here of the variables. So, that we will discuss now. Before that, you please copy it down so that we can go to the next slide. It is very easy question. First condition is very easy, and second condition also, if you use your knowledge that all of you know that lion is having 4 legs and peacock is having 2 legs. So even if, as I have said, you can skip these two statements directly, also you can write down from the second condition 4x plus 2y is equal to 140. It is not compulsory that you should specify these things. As I have said, I have written this to make you understand how the equation has come. Okay. So here both the equations are ready. As you can see, you have to observe the coefficient. Here coefficient is 1 and here coefficient is 2. That means they are different. They are not equal. But here, see, here nothing is seen means one is there. Here also one is there. Means coefficient of y are equal. Also, what we can find is their sign is same. Both the places we are having plus sign. That means addition will not help us surely. So we have to go for subtraction. But now while writing the subtraction, that subtracting which equation from which equation, so you have to observe the bigger number here. See, here you can see that 70 is bigger. So to avoid negative numbers, what we are going to do is, we are going to subtract equation 1 from 2. Okay, 2 will appear up and 1 will appear down, so that we will not get negative answer. So always be careful about that. You subtract in such a way that the bigger number appears first, or the equation with bigger number, it appears first. Here also you can see 2x is bigger than x. So while writing, what we are going to write? Subtracting equation 1 from 2. Okay, so let us write subtracting equation 1 from 2. So equation 2 will appear first. What is equation 2? 2x plus y is equal to 70. Then we have minus sign. Then we are going to write equation 1. X plus y is equal to 50. Now when we subtract here, always we change the signs of second equation. Each and every sign we need to change. Okay. So this plus is going to become minus. Again this plus is going to become minus. And this plus has become minus. Okay. So all the signs are changed. Now see, plus y and minus y, they will cancel each other. And here, 2x minus x, we are going to get x. And here, 70 minus 50, that is 20. So what we are going to get, x is equal to 20. In this way, we have got the value of variable x. Now let us substitute this in any one equation here. So what we can find here is equation 1 is easier. So let us substitute x is equal to 20 in equation 1. Okay. So what is equation 1? X plus y is equal to 50. So replace this x by 20. So what we will get? Therefore, 20 plus y is equal to 50. In place of x, we are writing 20. We are substituting 20 in place of x. And therefore, this 20 we will shift to right hand side. That is, it will become y is equal to 50 minus 20, that is equal to 30, correct? So we got the value of variable y also. Okay, now the last thing to write down the final answer. What was our question? We have to find out the number of lions and number of peacocks. Okay, so we can write down the final answer as, therefore the number of lions are 20 and number of peacocks are 30. Or you can write, there are 20 lions and 30 peacocks in the zoo. Okay, I hope you must have understood the question. Please copy it down. Be careful here while subtracting. This minus sign shows subtraction. And these are the changes in sign. As I have said, if you want, you can ignore this. If you don't want to write it, you can avoid writing that. But you have to be very careful while writing the answer. Okay? But in hurry, if you don't change the signs and if you forget to subtract, then you can add also and then you can get the wrong answer also. So to be on safer side, always try to change the signs of the second equation. Okay, and don't forget to write down the final answer as a statement. So let us go towards the next question now from practice set 5.2. That is question number 5 here. Sanjay gets fixed monthly income. every year there is a certain increment in his salary. After 4 years, his monthly salary was rupees 4,500. And after 10 years, his monthly salary became 5,400 rupees. Then find his original salary and yearly increment. Okay, so here the person Sanjay, his income is fixed. And that income has two parts. First part is what? His original salaries. That means the salary he got in the first year. And afterwards, every year he is getting yearly increment. Okay, so these two things we need to find. So we are going to assign variables X and Y here. We will take the original salary as rupees X and the yearly increment as rupees Y. This is the first thing that we are going to do. That let the original salary of Sanjay be rupees X and the yearly increment is rupees Y. So that is our first statement. Okay, so let Sanjay's fixed monthly salary be rupees X and yearly increment be rupees Y. Okay, so here this is fixed salary and, or you can write down original salary here, and this increment is what? Y. The salary which is decided in the first year, fixed monthly salary. Okay, so now see the first condition. After 4 years, his monthly salary was rupees 4,500. So after completion of 4 years, how many increments he is going to get? 4 increments. So the increment amount will be what? 4y. But the fixed salary which was in the beginning, that is not going to change. Okay, so what we can write down from the first condition is X plus 4y is equal to rupees 4,500. Okay, fixed salary plus the increment of 4 years. So we have multiplied here by 4. And that was how much? Rupees 4,500. So we wrote that as equal to 4,500. This is our equation 1. Now see the second condition. After 10 years, the salary became 5,400. That means 10 increments he are going to get. So from the second condition, what we can write down is X plus 10Y is equal to 5,400. If you are writing this first equation, it is very easy for you to write down the second equation. After 10 years, means after completion of 10 years, 10 increments we are going to add to the original salary or the fixed salary. So this is our second equation. Okay. Now, equations are ready. So all of you write down these equations. Then we will solve them. Always read the question carefully. If you don't understand the question, read it again to understand it better. Once the equations are framed correctly, solving it is very easy because you know the method. You have solved so many examples. So you can solve it. And you have only one method to solve it. So after practicing it, it is easy for you to follow that method. Okay, so the next thing is to solve. So observe the coefficients here. See here the coefficients are equal. Here they are different. So there is no need of multiplication here, or there is no question of equating the coefficients here. So here what more we can observe is sign is also same, positive. So we have to subtract. Again, I told you in the previous example that always think of bigger number. So in equation 2 we have bigger number. So subtract equation 1 from 2. What we are going to write? Subtracting equation 1 from 2. 2 will appear up, 1 will appear down. Okay, so write down. Subtracting equation 1 from 2. Okay, so equation number 2. X plus 10Y is equal to 5,400. minus equation 1, x plus 4y is equal to 4500. Since we are subtracting, we need to change the signs. So everywhere minus sign is written because all of them are positive. Correct? Now let us subtract. This x and this x plus x and minus x cancelled. 10y minus 4y, what we are going to get? 6y here. And 5400 minus 4500, we are going to get 900. So what we got? 6y is equal to 900. And therefore y is equal to 900 divided by 6, that is y is equal to 150. Okay, so we got the value of one variable, that is y. Let us put this value in any one equation here. Okay, so I am choosing equation 1 because it is simpler little bit. So put y is equal to 150 in equation 1. So what is our equation 1? You can see here. Okay, and in place of y, we are going to write 150. See, x plus 4 inside the bracket 150, y is replaced by 150, that is equal to 4500. Now 4 into 150 is how much? 600. So what is our next step? X plus 600 is equal to 4500. Now shift this 600 to right hand side. So X is equal to 4500 minus 600, that is 3600. So we got value of both the variables, X as well as Y. So we can write down the final answer of the statement. Therefore the fixed monthly salary or the original salary is what? Rupees 3900, and the yearly increment is rupees 150. Okay, so write down. Therefore Sanjay's monthly salary is rupees 3900 and yearly increment is rupees 150. Okay, please copy it down. Write down all the steps very carefully. Here you can use the word original salary also. Okay. Algebra is all about signs. Here if you are making mistake in one sign, then you are going to get the complete question wrong. So you have to be very careful about signs. While writing, you try to understand and write it. And as I have said, that keep habit of writing it immediately. Don't think that I will take out screenshot, I will write it afterwards. No, because you know that if you understand it properly, then you don't need to prepare it again and again. And I have made you understand the importance of this chapter, that why it is important. Okay. So please always keep habit of writing the things immediately and properly. Don't forget to write down the final answer as a statement. Okay students, now question number 6 is remaining from practice sets 5.2, that we will discuss in the next lecture, and then we will start with problem set. Okay, so today we are stopping here students. Till that, you stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you students.